You know what that sound is? That's a seal. Sylvester the seal. And I'm going to tell you a story about Sylvester. One beautiful morning, Sylvester woke very early. He yawned. He stretched his whiskers, then he stretched his flippers. Finally, he stretched his tail and thought about breakfast. Then he remembered what day it was. Boy, he wriggled off the bed, took out his horn from under his pillow where he always kept it, and tried a few practice toots just to see how it worked. Oh, this was the day of all days. Sylvester was going to try for a job on a jazz band. So he started right in practicing his scales. And he dreamed about the fame and the fortune which he, Sylvester, the very musical seal, was going to find. But now it was time to get ready. Sylvester jumped into his tub of water, came out all wet and shiny. Then he had his breakfast, three fish, one right after the other. He put his horn under his flipper and seesawed down the stairs. Then he hurried along the street until he came to the rehearsal room of that famous band leader and his orchestra, none other than Benny Bunny and his Broadway band. He went right in and sat there waiting for his turn to play, thinking about how hard he had practiced. While he was waiting, in walked a cat with a clarinet in his paw. The cat was very brightly dressed in a long checkered coat and an orange tie. He sat down next to Sylvester and started to shine up his clarinet.
Good morning, said Sylvester.
Name's Danny, said the cat.
You don't mean Danny the Hep Cat, All-American Animal Clarinet Champion.
Yep, that's right. What's your name?
My name's Sylvester. I'm trying out for a job with Benny Bunny. I used to play trumpet in a circus.
Circus? But circus music is different than jazz music, said Danny. You have a lot to learn. Just then, the door to the tryout room opened and somebody shouted, "Next!" Sylvester wriggled right in, while Danny smiled and waited to see what would happen. At first, there was silence inside the room. Then Danny heard Sylvester play.
Well, that's awful, thought Danny. You'll never get a job here playing that way.
Everything was quiet for a moment, and then the door opened and Sylvester came out very slowly, his little tin horn dragging along the floor, his whiskers drooping down below his chin.
Next,
shouted the voice. Danny whispered to Sylvester,
wait here till I come out.
And he hurried into the office. Then Sylvester sat down feeling very sad. He thought he'd played his piece so well, even faster than he'd ever played it before. But Benny Bunny had only held his hands over his ears. Nope. No job in a jazz band for Sylvester the Seal. He guessed he wasn't a very musical seal after all. Sylvester sat there dejected for a moment, and then he heard Danny playing. As he listened to Danny's clarinet, he felt worse and worse. He was sure he could never play like that. Then Danny came out, smiling and waving to Benny Bunny inside. He turned to Sylvester.
Well, I got a job, he said.
Sylvester tried to hide his horn under his flipper. Then Danny said to Sylvester,
you see, you have to play jazz to get a job here. You could if you tried, but first you have to forget the way you play now and catch on to the jazz style. Hey, and you know what? I'll help you. Come on, let's go.
So Danny and Sylvester walked out together. One, a very up-to-date musical cat, and the other, a very old-fashioned musical seal. As they walked along together, Danny explained to Sylvester that up-to-date rhythm was the first thing you need for good jazz.
Just listen to the rhythm we make while we walk, he said.
Then they walked along the waterfront.
Did you ever hear the rhythm that the boats in the harbor make?
Danny asked.
You can get some good musical ideas from them.
Further on, some workmen were repairing the street.
Listen to that air drill, said Danny. You can make rhythm out of that, too.
taxi tooted its horn.
You see, everything has music. Every day, all around us, we hear wonderful rhythms and sounds.
Well, they came to Sylvester's house and slowly went up the stairs to his room. Sylvester climbed into the tub of water.
Oh, I'm sorry,
he cried as Danny jumped out of the way of a big splash. And then while Sylvester sat in the tub with just his head sticking out, Danny began to tell him about the spirit and the feeling of jazz. How it grew out of the troubles and the joys of people who love to use music to talk about things. And how the blues change when people laugh. And he told him all about the music of New Orleans, where jazz was born. And how it changed a little when it came north to Chicago. A saxophone was added, and then new musical patterns were played. And then it spread everywhere. And people played jazz all over the country. So Danny said,
tell you what, meet you here tonight and we'll go out and hear some more real jazz firsthand.
Sylvester looked at Danny over the edge of the tub and asked sort of excitedly,
oh, shall I bring my horn too?
Not tonight, Sylvester. You just listen tonight.
That evening, Danny met Sylvester and they started out. Danny wore a blue suit with red stripes running through it and was all dressed up from head to tail. He wore a bright necktie and, of course, he would never forget his smaller but equally bright tail tie. Sylvester had on his best suit with pearl buttons down the front and a little round hat pulled down over one eye. He had his whiskers shaped up real sharp. Gosh, he even had on some aftershave lotion. As they walked along, they heard the music of a wonderful band. But before Sylvester could find out what the band was playing, he was led into a little restaurant with tables so small you couldn't put more than two fish on any one of them. Danny and Sylvester sat down at the table nearest the band.
Hi, Danny,
waved one of the musicians in the band.
Bring your clarinet.
You bet I did,
Danny called back.
I'll be there in a minute. Now, Sylvester, I'm going to sit in with this band, and we're going to have a jam session. That means we just take any tune and play it the way we feel. Now, you sit right there and listen. Listen to the tune they play and to what each musician does with the tune when he plays a solo. You understand about jazz then, and I'll be back after a few numbers. Oh, look, and listen, if you're going to have fish for dinner, will you ask the waiter to bring me an order of catnip? I hear it's real good here.
Okay. I'll do that, and I'll be right here listening very carefully, said Sylvester.
Well, Danny walked up to the band, took out his clarinet, then they all began to play, and every whisker under Sylvester's nose jumped to the rhythm of the band. And he clapped his flippers so the band would play another number. Then Danny stood up and called,
Hey, Sylvester, here's one of your old circus numbers, but listen to the way we play it.
Danny came back to the table with some of the musicians. Sylvester was real excited, and he talked about all the different solos he heard and how much he liked them. He felt that he was beginning to get the knack of jazz. And he knew that he had the sense of the rhythm because he could feel that from the tip of his tail to the top of his head. He wanted to run home and get his horn and practice all night long. And every time the band played again, Sylvester would swing and sway. He'd tap his tail, flap his flippers. He even forgot his manners. And when he got too noisy and outspoken, the manager had to come up and tell him,
"Now look here, I'm sorry, but we don't allow barking at the table."
The next morning, almost before the sun came in the window, Sylvester was up. He had his dip in the tub and was out again so fast there was hardly time to even feel the water curling over his smooth hide. He bolted down three fish, one after the other, and was all set to practice. He took his horn from under the pillow and began to play. He felt the music inside him now. First, he tried a simple melody. And then he sort of, well, played around with a little tune, adding his own twists and turns. All morning he practiced. He got better and better, until all the tunes he heard the night before came back to him, and he added his own ideas to make them suit him. After lunch, Sylvester set out again for another tryout for that same Benny Bunny's famous Broadway band. He went back to that rehearsal room with his horn under his flipper and his whiskers pointing in all directions. He walked in and sat down in the chair again until he heard the voice inside shout, "Next!" And then he loped right into that office. At the end of the audition, the door opened and Sylvester came out, and after him came the great Benny Bunny himself, all smiles.
"Wonderful," he said. "I want to shake your flipper. You're hired. I'm going to put you in with my new greater band. And listen, I want you to be soloist. You'll be marvelous."
Sylvester tucked his horn under his flipper and walked out, feeling very musical all of a sudden and very happy. Danny met him that night, and they went back to listen to the band again. Danny had his clarinet, and Sylvester had taken his trumpet just in case. They heard the music playing as they walked in and sat down at the table nearest the band, and Danny went up and sat with the other musicians. As the band began to play, Sylvester took his horn from under the table, polished it a little with the side of his nose, and hopped up to the front of the bandstand. All of a sudden, he began to play better than he'd ever played before. Shouted Danny.
"Fill in a solo!"
shouted the bass player.
"Take a Philly up solo!"
shouted the manager, throwing him a mackerel.
"The place is yours!"